Sang ești în nume de voie.
Tu când am dat și la ce părășuri, Doam cu rugă, am
atâta gente e ce cânta. Teta mergi tu din ei, tambi sunt legend semneba. Drubi mergi un tabgreta, semgi cundru, mulți tu ieși ce gente. Ma, te gai o tigita. De. Da. Nu, omul, 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 亲戚马老板下去洗碗汤
So this leads us to the second topic of the two that we're discussing, the correct way in which to introduce this and the way that this is held by the author of the text, Panchen Losang Chugyen. And so he says in verse 27, although that is the case, this way of doing it is the way in which beginners place their minds, achieve mental stabilization. And it is an excellent method for accomplishing that, a skillful means which is excellent for accomplishing that that initial placement of the mind. And this is, and I, Chugyi Gensen, say that this is the way in which one introduces the phenomenal character of the mind, the mind's phenomenal character. And then the next verse, 28, says, now with regard to the nature of the mind, how the way in which one is to introduce the nature of the mind, I'm going to present here the instruction which I received from the mouth of my root guru, who completely removed all of the darkness which confused my mind, and my root guru took on the the mode of holding the saffron robes. And his name is mentioned in the text here, where it says he's the gnosis of all the Buddhas. That's his name, and so this second verse then is a promise to present that.
Oh yeah, that Gowarang Monji Jesu Jane. Ani shenji teta sui mechi, teta mechi, isaite. Ani ranglu jiongzu di samni, ani kondu xiaba tar, ranglu ki simmi mi bi xine, kondu xiaba tar. Mi ba qiaba jian, sen la mi ba ta. Xiong dan tun bi menga jizu, jiongzu yin bai. Dan kansu ri ta, du jia le tangpo bi simni, le tangpo bi le jian nam ji. Ani toma, Sine
So then the Zintri on this, the sub-commentary says that this other way of explaining it, the incorrect way, is due to following confusion, a confused understanding of it. And so, although some say that it is like that, out of the from due to the confusion that they're following, However, with regard to our own system of explaining this, this way of maintaining the mind focused upon using shamatha to focus on the clear cognitive nature of the mind, the phenomenal character of the mind, as previously explained, here this has is a special object. The object which is observed is the mind. So in that respect, and then it's also a way in which one preserves the mind, one maintains focus on the phenomenal character of the mind, which accords, this sort of special instruction accords with the great texts, if done properly. And that being the case, this is a marvelous method for achieving mental stabilization, meaning here shamatha, is for beginners, and is an especially skillful means, and this is then the way in which one introduces one to the merely phenomenal character of the mind, the phenomenal mind, and so that's an explanation of that verse, and or the first part of that verse. And so here then he says that in dependence upon the tradition of Jelama, I, Losang Chugi Gensen, having understood all of the correct reasonings that are employed for establishing this, I say that. And where he says, I say this, what he said above, that this is a promise to explain the actual subject here. So here, where it says the mere, in the sub-commentary, the mere phenomenality of the mind, or the mere phenomenal character of the mind, that should be construed as referring to this clear cognitive character of the mind, just that. But it's not referring to ascertaining that the mind is merely phenomenal. There's a distinction that has to be made here. That is, one is being introduced to the phenomenal character of the mind, but in that way of meditating upon, developing shamatha by focusing upon the clarity and cognitive character of the mind, but one is not, by means of that, able to ascertain that the mind is merely phenomenal, meaning that it's merely a phenomenal reality. In order to determine, ascertain that the mind is a mere phenomenal reality, one would have to previously have ascertained that the mind is empty of being real. And this is explained in it's important to understand this as it's taught in both the greater and shorter Lamrim texts.
That you changing what it is with that. Ani shaba tan shaba tan duba duba nyam su len su ni chewe na ne. Ta yu chini o shaba tan shaba la o ta ni sem ji chini la ngo zhi qi da cha yu zhu. O kwa su re san jie yi xie san jie nam ji yi xie gu ngo mi zin bi zhu su ne.
So So here then, the next verse is a promise to express this, or rather the next topic that we've come to here is the way in which one introduces one the student, disciple, to the nature. Nature here of the object. We've already gone through the way in which the subject aspect of this has been introduced. The nature of the perceiving subject now is the way in which the nature of the object here is introduced, and this is given in the next verse 28. And first there's a promise to explain this, and then the way in which by practicing it, how one is to to practice this. So the first of these is that he says, the root text says, now with respect to how one is to be introduced to the nature of the mind, I'm going to present the oral instruction that I received from my root guru, who dispelled all of the darkness of confusion from my mind, and my guru who had taken up the mode of, or presented himself as a monk who held the saffron robes, who was who was the entirety of the gnosis of the Buddhas. So this is explained in the sub-commentary where it says, now is the first word in the verse is a transitional, and then and transition, and it's showing that here this is also a meaning that has the sense of that now is going to be taught the actual Mahamudra, which is different from the mere shamatha, which was previously explained. So the mere shamatha that was previously explained was focusing on the phenomenal character of the mind, and now the actual Mahamudra will be explained. So if you say, what is that? Having been introduced to the mind, having been introduced to it, in the way that was previously explained through developing shamatha with respect to the phenomenal character of the mind, then based upon that meditation that one's developed, then one is introduced to the reality of the mind, which is the basis of emptiness. The mind is the basis of the emptiness here. And so that's what it is.
Oh yeah. Then what did Chitar tell you so kind of is and I agree. Sanjay Nam Ji Shoki, one meeting with Susan, I say, and I love you, Sanjay Shoki. I need Chitar combat and Tumba tried him, but take Chitar tell you so in the church, Sanjay Nam Ji Shoki, do it, Danny. Oh, I need Tingy duty. I know number some day. Ani ngomi zimbi kelongi tsusune. Ani duja tumo win angoro. Benji losan chejan dagi. Ani ka lomombi maribi mba sevi. Dreme. Likto kunji zawi lama. Kedu sanje yije ze chen. Tuandang tumba di. Siale chungi. Ta yensan yin juki tamba. Ani
So then, again, to repeat the last little part, it says that this is the introduction to the reality of the mind, which is the basis of the emptiness here. The nature of the mind, which is the basis of the emptiness. So then, how is he going to do that? The way in which he will, the author, Panchen Losang Chögyal-Gyaltsen will do that. He says that the commentary is referring to the root guru from whom Panchen Losang Chögyal received this instruction. His name, if we utter it, would be Kirup Sangye Yeshe, and he was the root guru commentary here explains the wording of the root text, where it says that he was a being that combined within himself all of the gnosis of the Buddhas of the 10 directions. At the time that Panchen Losang Chögyal received this instruction from him, he took up the mode of appearance of a monk who held the three saffron robes at that time, and then doing that within the sort of way it appeared to ordinary people, or in sort of the way it appeared in an ordinary sense. He was able to serve as a lamp that was able to clarify entirely, dispel all of the darkness of ignorance, which confused my mind, and my mind referring here to Panchen Losang Chögyal's his own mind. And so from his mouth, I received the instruction on the Insan Yingyu, the oral instruction coming through from Gyawa Insapa. And previously, that had not been placed in writing due to the force of the times that it was being transmitted. It wasn't placed in written down. But I now, Panchen Losang Chögyal, will hear as in the form of an instruction that leads one to the experience of this, will place this in writing. So that's the meaning of this, that statement in verse 28. And this is clear from the colophon that is found, colophon that's found at the end of the root text.
Oh yeah, that's one day last. Shabba Tamsa Lansum Chuna Yang, Gawaiwa Maris. Tambo de Chachin Chi, Tamba Chi to be Tamsa Che. Niwa de Yujin Simo Drubak Tamsa Che. Tanda Divi Tamsa De, Ani Yuchini to be Chachin Mugi, Tamsa Yimbe, Dejin Meba, that Andrela, I guess, Sundan Hashi Chani. Tamja jo minja wa ngama namda deyu jen medo chani suwa na shi chani chute nyingi tsam mano waro ngayi simbi gawa yoto shilaki chute nyinga ki tsam mano wa ngayi simbi gawa yoto tamja chima degi tamja chimi kapti ni shilaki chute nyingi tsam mano wa ngayi simbi gawa yoto tena
So then, as far as here in this text, there's three promises to explain. However, although there are three of them, the first of these is a promise to teach the general instruction on Mahamudra. The second one is the promise to introduce the mind as the perceiving subject. And the third is the promise to teach the actual Mahamudra, which is the introduction to the objective nature, the object as nature as object here. So therefore, there's no fault of redundancy, and that's explained in the auto commentary where it says, although there are three different ways in which I've presented this promise to explain, there's no fault here of redundancy with respect to the former promises to explain. And here in the context of the latter promise to explain, there's also the purpose of identifying without any error the boundary between shamatha and vipassana in terms of both the words and the meanings of shamatha and vipassana. Those shamatha and insight have to be differentiated. So this third promise to explain has that purpose as well.
Oh yeah, that's it. Don't you tell a choice you come back on my today is and so on. I see any. Don't you get our knee? And a choice you love me. You bears you. Only charging huge charger, charging. And a don't you do a dawa knee? And a call a trove, choice you love me. You bear. And a don't you do with our the charging machine. Gomba Shinetam, Shinetam Gombani, Tawa Tobi, Tapsam, Tawak, Porting, Yanatam, Yimbe, Anne, a charging Mushi Miyang, Mares, Mainaya, Kondun Dilla, Jomu, Jusum, Shivy, Kabji, Shinang, Mushi Sumbati, O Dilla, Jomu, Jusum, Shivy, Kabji, Shinang, Mushi Sumbati, Simiji, Shinetam, Anne.
So therefore, with respect to the view of emptiness, that is the actual path that liberates one. And therefore, that is the actual subject of Mahamudra, and mere development of shamatha, the meditating shamatha, is a method for achieving, for seeking the view, for searching for the view, or is a mere sort of adjunct which enhances the view, but it's not the actual Mahamudra. And even though that's the case, in the text, it said, here, with among the three topics, there's the preparation, the actual subject, and then, or the actual primary subject, and then the conclusion. What happens after one has done the main practice? It says there within that, the author Panchen Losung Chögyen has taught the shamatha as if it was part of the main session or main practice. This his reason for doing that is so that he would be able to be able to lead along to draw in others who consider the mere development of shamatha, which takes mind as the observed object, as they accept those who accept that as Mahamudra, such as some of the earlier Tibetan scholars. So that's one purpose for him presenting shamatha as part of the actual, the main portion of Mahamudra. And then also within our own tradition as well, by means of shamatha, having shamatha and one then observes the nature of the mind,
Sundra Kumbaki wants to shower it. She loves Sundra Kumbati charging. 유지 찾아 공부하러
So then, even within our own tradition as well, or he's done that also due to, or by because of within our own tradition as well. There's one meditates by joining shamatha, that kind of shamatha which focuses on the mind. And within the context of coordinating shamatha and vipassana in a coordinated pair, and then with that observing the nature of the mind.
Oh yeah, that under the caso, ani dila sabje ni zeni yongu arre thana dila wote jie wa chit tempa dang theta kinyumbu trine tempa ase chi ni yongu arre, ya. That day, my Gangashimoga chair. That I go to the Jit and Bar said that that did the water Nala Tamadu. Then that I go up, because Jit and Bar said, what do you hear what Jit and Bar said that Mama Tambo Commandam Sheba Casually Sheba Temba is a symptom of Sanjay Sanjay by him, Sanjay Shendu Misa Shevata, Sarah Gray, semi chipo. Simi 도지왕기 천인 딜라스 콘도 샤바기 아니 도지왕기 뭐지 캐마 캐와 대다기 아니 송주 만보 여봐 아니 천인 딜라 송주 만보 여봐 심지 군주의 천인의 천인 샤바 다 도지왕기 세주 만보 여봐 여봐 예상 도지왕기 천인 대라 지 탐반 남지 我 주주기 여봐 샤바 마양 다 니 가서는 Diri teta ki nyingbo dine tenpa sunbe se, ta chechen ki dine kaso. Dini tanyi namba jebi se ikana, ni o tahtatang, chetanyi namba jebi, su shendang minrawe, umi lam chishin se ikana, ta o tonyi umi lam se na, ta yu tongpa ni ta yu jen, uma nika la cha yu jiri, umi lam chishin sawa tenpa,
So then it says, if one presents this in accordance with the way it's done in the auto commentary, that is Losang Chugyen's own commentary to his root text, here in the auto commentary, it's on page 85 of the Tibetan of that, it's on a comment on verse 28. Then there are various presentations of the way in which one introduces the nature of the mind, and these are presented in the way various masters, for example, Dumba and Saraha, etc., have presented explanations of how one is introduced to the nature of the mind. And those explanations, some of them on the surface are easily confusable, can be confused or can give rise to confusion. And then others are, but if they're understood correctly, the ones that are coming from the authoritative masters, then they can all be understood as according with the way in which it is presented subsequently within the text itself. At the end of, after going through some of these other ways of introducing the nature of the mind, Panchen Losang Chugyen then says at the end, now we'll deal with the way in which one is led into the Madhyamaka view. And so that here, if we explain that in accordance with the auto commentary, then in accordance with the different types of disciples, the people to be trained, in general, there are lots of different ways in which the noble beings introduce different manners and modes in which they these noble beings introduced people, students, disciples to this nature. However, here, if we combine all of those into their sort of essence and teach them in that way, then this way of doing it is the system which is the which was taught by the Lord, who is the heart of Manjushri, and that is a way of cutting through the two extremes, the extreme of eternalism and the extreme of annihilationism or nihilism, which is different from all others. And this Lord, who is the heart of Manjushri, has taught this extremely clearly in accordance with the Madhyamaka path, the middle path.
Oh yeah, that here I carry this and she need to be a good soul. That's so good. That time, then that time, Kondo, today, London, Chawa, Nashi, Chani, and the Lord, you do go so. Some then some, like one you, Jarute, Shana, you, Maria, Ambush, Tana, give me, Bakunajo, listen, let's review, Dejente, Teta, Shana, Nanjo, Ambona, Namita, Tinzin, Gentu, then, Shesumba, Samji, Ta, Yage, Kondushiwa, Nashi, Anishine, Duke, Satin, Sumba, Samji, Drumni, Anishine, Tanyba, or Tendit, Kondushaba, Nashi, Drumni. Sumba, Give me back, Something to Seba Suvi, Chibonam Zabala, and if Zabale, Yabchovach it is.
So here then is quoted an passage from Jerumpche's Songs of Experience, and this illustrates that this is the system, the tradition of Jerumpche, who's the essence, who has at his heart Manjushri. And so that says that. This meditative concentration, which is the king, which gives one, which dominates and has control over the mind, if one places the mind in that, and then it becomes unmoving, like the king of mountains, Mount Meru, and if one directs it, it's able to engage in all of the different kinds of virtuous objects. It brings about the great bliss, which makes the body and mind very workable. Having understood that, then all mighty yogis and yoginis should destroy the enemy of distraction, and constantly rely upon meditative concentration. So, just as he has said, that's the quotation from the Song of Experience. Just as he said, if one has accomplished meditative concentration, that being the case, saying that is sufficient, here then is what follows is a kind of excursus discussing a kind of wrong way of misconstruing what proper way of meditative, what the purpose of meditative concentration is. And so someone who says that that's enough, that meditative concentration alone is adequate, and who fixes their mind on a single object and maintains it that way for a long period of time, they're a person who doesn't understand what the principal purpose of shamatha is. What this is, the purpose of shamatha actually is so that by using investigative wisdom, one is able to open up the door of all of the different dharma expositions. And once one has done that, if one then directs one's mind into that that objective, then the mind won't go anywhere else from where one has directed it. And this enables one to engage in all of the kinds of virtuous objects that one is interested in without any kind of obstruction. So that's the way it is properly done. But people who don't understand that correctly gain very little profit from that by engaging in meditative concentration. It doesn't provide them with much benefit, even if they're considered to be ascetics or people who are attempting to practice virtue. And in particular, if one does not meditate upon this in such a way that one is, to the extent of one's ability, able to focus on the object, which is selflessness, then
Ani khasor, chapa tuyan dang mi bi tuyan la nuwa yue zhe chi jene dong li chita wala mi bi lang dong mi du mi rung ma mi mi rung yin ba xie xin du ani mi gong ba di ani khasor, sam xin du si ba su yi sen ba sen ba nam ji ani zhe ba le jab chi cho ba chi re jab chi cho ba.
So here then, someone who meditates, develops meditative concentration in that way, and then doesn't utilize it to develop insight, which investigates the nature of reality, then someone who, even though they have the ability to develop that kind of, or they have the capacity to develop that kind of vipassana, or insight meditation, that could understand the nature of selflessness, and they understand that insight is indispensable for developing that by observing reality just as it is. But they understand that, but they don't develop that. They don't develop insight. Then these are such persons have definitely turned their backs on the activities of the great beings, bodhisattvas, who have deliberately taken up existence in the world.
Ani tiba memba tamji lam le jang ring du kho gre taba thenyi gu lo tamya ma je na tima yang gi rani ji bi du taba thenyi gu lo tamya ma je na taba de bi tiba membi lam le jang ring du kho shi do na kho wan do na kho yi sa be be wa la cho du ji wi yang wa ma bang wa shi go ani kho yi sa be be wa ma do sa be ji ba ma yin ba kho wa ji
And not only have they turned their backs on the activities of the bodhisattvas, but they've also deviated along, they've strayed a long way from the path, which is the mere path of the Hinayana, which is oneself desiring to attain liberation from the entirety of samsara, where one has a constant wish to achieve liberation from samsara. They've strayed even from that path. And in brief, not only that, but they are people who consider meditative concentration alone to be sufficient. The kind of shamatha that we've mentioned so far, the simply focusing on the phenomenal character of the mind without then using that shamatha to analyze and investigate the actual nature of reality as such. They have not given up, in the text it says they haven't given up the extremely dangerous condition of cherishing to the highest degree expanding the seed of samsara, meaning that this kind of attachment to that kind of meditative concentration actually increases one's engagement in samsara. Thus, that being the case, not only is it the case that one needs to seek the view based upon meditation as has been presented, that is, first one develops shamatha and then uses that meditation that one's developed as a platform for finding the view. But even those who have already previously gotten the view need to it's appropriate for such persons to be extremely focused on developing and finding a shamatha, that kind of meditation, as an adjunct for the enhancement and the further acquisition of the view and the development of one's understanding of the view, without just stringing together a bunch of different meditative objects, but instead simply based upon this very the view itself, then they should focus very intently upon seeking that kind, searching for that kind of shamatha meditation for developing the view itself.
Thus,
So this is as it's explained in again in, as stated in the Songs of Experience by Jerumche, where it says that I have not seen a single-pointed meditative concentration, which is able to cut through the root of samsara, meaning that single-pointed meditation alone, it doesn't have the ability to cut through the root of samsara, unless it's conjoined with insight, which is the wisdom that investigates and understands the nature of reality or emptiness. So I haven't seen that, Jerumche says. And likewise, any form of wisdom which is separate from the path of shamatha, here referring to insight or wisdom that one has, but that is not stabilized by means of the path of shamatha. However much one investigates by means of that kind of wisdom, it's not able to avert the mental afflictions. So what that is saying is that the wisdom that understands the nature of reality, unless it is based upon shamatha, which is able to stabilize the mind and have the mind function as a stable platform for doing the kind of investigation and analysis with wisdom, then there's no way to get rid of the mental afflictions. The mental afflictions here are principally, especially referring to the misapprehension of the self, which is the root of samsara, and that misapprehension of the self is only eradicated completely when one has the wisdom that understands, has investigated the nature of reality and understands emptiness correctly. That kind of wisdom has shamatha as a foundation upon which it then is able to eliminate actually the misconception of the self. So he says there, since wisdom which is separate from the path of shamatha is not able to avert to eliminate the mental afflictions, no matter how much one investigates things by means of it, analyzes things by means of it, then one has to take that wisdom which has precisely determined the way things are. Precisely determined the way things are refers to using correct forms of reasoning. One precisely delineates the way things exist, separating out ways that they don't exist. Here, this is tantamount to freeing oneself from the two extremes, the extreme of things existing in the way they don't actually exist, and then the other extreme of holding that things don't exist at all, or that they exist in some way that doesn't coincide with their actual reality. So that kind of wisdom, which has precisely determined the way things is, if that is mounted upon the horse of unwavering shamatha, then and then one takes up the weapon of awareness, which is aware of the middle way, free from the two extremes. Then, with that weapon of awareness, one is able to destroy entirely the focal points, which serve as the bases for misapprehending things in an extreme way, existing in ways that they don't, or exaggerating them, or underestimating the way things actually exist. And then, by means of that, then. by means of the wisdom, which is extensive in terms of its the proper analysis and investigation of things, by means of that wisdom, then he says, I have made my intellect extremely vast, such that it can has understood a reality. So here it says that by having previously cultivated single-pointed meditation previously, by means of that, one who has accomplished meditative concentration in that way, what needs to be said of that? If one has done that, then now by means of investigative wisdom as well, if one is able to, has first developed meditative concentration, and then after that is able through using it for I'm sorry, I'm getting tangled up in the words here. If one then employs the investigative wisdom to understand the way things actually are, and then the way things actually are is shorthand for emptiness, and then if one has generated this meditative concentration, which is extremely stable, unwavering, and is focused upon emptiness, the way things are, then you take that earlier developed shamatha, and the insight that one has developed subsequently through investigation, and someone who makes effort to accomplish both of those, such that they are simultaneously conjoined into a cooperating pair, then that is extremely marvelous. And this is explained in a subsequent verse also.
Oh yeah. 大家看说的先生天哪啊天哪让家地里错那么讲是大地孙队看了给咱家没了那路都比写着孙队主把那最没看的这么阴阳明的这么阴阳看阴阳他们连接切近年把你心里的一着我这个的咱前年起来的心里的啊你
So then the verse that is actually explaining follows the explanation. And the verse here again is from the lines of experience. And it says, by meditating single-pointedly and developing meditative concentration in that way, what needs to be said of that? It's good, but by properly analyzing and using investigative wisdom, and if one is able to generate the meditative concentration, which abides in an extremely stable fashion without any kind of wavering, And then if one strives to develop that, produce that so that one brings both shamatha and insight together into a pair, then that is extremely marvelous. So that's the verse. And then it says that being the case, then those of us who have gathered together here, even if we're people that are not striving to accomplish this integration or coordination of shamatha and insight, so as to be able to understand the way things are, even if we're not doing that at the moment, we're not striving to develop that, then just the mere fact that we're here right now with one of us explaining it and the others listening to this is it's something that it's appropriate to be extremely joyful about. So then the benefits here of listening to this kind of a teaching, explaining it and listening to it, are mentioned is illustrated by a quote from the Diamond Cutter Sutra Vajracchedaka, and there it says that the Lord said, Bhagavan has said, O Subhuti, what do you think? How many grains of sand are there in the stream of the Ganga River? And if you took all of as many grains of sand as there are in the stream of the Ganga, and you made that into each of those grains of sand into another Ganga, Ganga River, Ganges River, and how many grains of sand would there be? Would they be? Would those be a lot, or what do you think? And then Subhuti said, "Oh Lord, oh Bhagavan, since the number of grains of sand in the stream of the Ganga is so many, then how many? What needs to be said of all of the grains of sand that would exist in that many Ganga rivers if they were multiplied in that way?" And then the Bhagavan said, "Oh Subhuti, you should believe this. You should understand this. If you took as many world systems as there are those number of grains of sand in all of those the streams of the all of those Ganga rivers, and you within all of those world systems, there were men or women who took up, filled them up, those world systems, with all of the different kinds, seven types of precious things, and then were to give those precious things, those worlds filled with the seven types of precious things, to Tathagata Arhats, Samyak Sambuddhas, to the Tathagata, to the Arhats, true fully awakened Buddhas, if they were give them, then O Subhuti, what do you think? Would those men or women from that on that basis, would they have generated a great deal of merit? And then Subhuti replied, "O Bhagavan, that would be a lot of merit. O Tathagata, that would be a great amount of merit. That men or women who did that would have, on that basis, would have generated a vast amount of merit." And so then the Bhagavan said, "O Subhuti, if you, even if you were to fill up all of that many number of world systems with these seven kinds of precious things, and to have given them to all of the Tathagata, Arhats, fully awakened Buddhas, if you were to do that, then rather than that, if someone was to take up a mere four-line verse from this Dharma exposition and was to properly explain it to others and was properly to teach it to others, then from that, on that basis, they would generate a massive merit, which would be innumerably greater than the amount of merit that was mentioned above."
Oh yeah. Tatini, Tati Jetela Ya Shaba Tamja Sadi, Shaba Tamja Vitela, Ta Nambi Nedego, Hong or Sungari. Wa Nambu Nedela, Nambu Nedela, Danita Omajubala Suana, say Chani, Gabdi, any Casuri, Chacha Chamba Nambu Nedela, Candy Kogu, Omajubala Sumana, say Chani, Society between a Tomba Nudena. Nandu rado kawa yanda yandu chu. Rado kawa lechu, chime mi lechu. Liji pabu kutawa chuwa kanyinba. Tela zobe sanje lobe sabi yu. Tini nyewa tembi nini te yinde. Tela tambi tunji temba temba cha. Tela teji jesu tuwe yende chung. Se o di imbari. Rwa. O di ni. So si jiwi tuine. Tomba nyuji tam tedi zamba. Ane rangla nandu kaso. Rado kawa yanda yandu chung haja. Don't you pay any attention?
So then his next, that was the identification of someone who's a suitable disciple for listening to this instruction. The next section, and that was showing the benefit of teaching and hearing this instruction. And then next comes a presentation of an exhortation, identification of the proper vessel for hearing this kind of teaching, and an exhortation to those who are proper vessels to listen carefully to this exposition of. Here it's again the objective of Mahamudra, which is emptiness, the nature of reality. So here it says, there's a quotation from the introduction to the Middle Way, which shows the vessel for listening to this kind of teaching. So here it says that even at the time a person is an ordinary individual, when they hear about emptiness, they become internally extremely delighted, and that delight occurs over and over again. And from that extreme delight that they experience, their eyes become wet with tears, and the hair on their body stands on end. So that sort of person is one who has the seed of the intellect, mind of a Buddha, of a fully awakened Buddha. And such a person is the vessel for this kind of instruction, and that sort of person is one to whom one should teach the reality, the ultimate reality, the reality which is the highest meaning, and for that person. The good qualities that follow after that kind of instruction will arise. So this is to explain that a little bit. So here's referring to even when one is an ordinary individual, if one hears instruction on emptiness and becomes delighted internally, and that delight occurs over and over again, and then these signs can appear where one's eyes will become wet with tears, the hair on one's body will stand on end, and that indicates then that such a person has this intellect of a Buddha, of a fully awakened Buddha, meaning that they have sort of the capacity to develop this understanding of the nature of reality in that time. And so then again, that is such a person is one to whom it's appropriate to give this kind of instruction, someone to whom the ultimate reality is to be taught, and such a person will give rise to the good qualities that follow upon that kind of instruction.
Oh, yeah. And the Jesus Bataji, Chi Luji Samatanam Jang, Stamp Luji Paputa, Lungagile, Tedang.
So then, regarding these signs that are mentioned within the introduction to the Middle Way, the root text, here these external signs that appear on the body this is referring to someone who has listened to a correct instruction on emptiness, and who has understood what they have heard, the meaning of what they have heard. Those two have to come together. Then those signs of tears and the goose pimples and so forth erroneous, are unmistakable signs that the person is a vessel for this kind of teaching. However, if someone doesn't understand the meaning of it, or even if they do understand it, and those signs don't arise, then it's not necessarily the case that they're rishik zabunutu mangepar rishik So someone who understands those and those signs don't arise, then for the time being, it's not certain that they are a vessel for the profound view here. And that's how it was explained by Jerumche in his comment, his explanation of the introduction to the Middle Way.
Oh yeah, that is it. That is it. That is what I saw. That is it. 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 Papa Tundi, Dadrawa, Tamjaki, Tamjani, Dadan, Dadrawa, Tamjani, Tomine, any Dule Jumijebe, say Tomine, any castle, Migigile, Jumajeba to Chebe, Tadunti, Mazamba, Tare, any carasana, Lucho, Tanjoji Dazan, Dinibi, Yaman Dilayan, any city Jidanki Chasha, Lenny High Leverage, Cheva. 통신 아니 미치마당 리지 바부 당기 미세바기 다산 마부 담발라 마데베 어 다인자 어 쳇바부글 천이당 아니 천이다 담바 중고와 말 다이나야 쳇이 그래서 사모도 비율에 대장스 사모든베기 베 그리신이 그 천이를 대와 이제 비율에 대장 다람니 쳇이 미면에 미봉아당스 아니 라신지 똥바인데 간에 취해 탐제 땀네 아니 군제 탐제 까봐 된대야 많이 봐 매와 따나 여장 리베 군제 탐제 까봐 코비 님으로 그 견니다 차요 왕도 최신
So that's the way I'm sorry. Vision calling you something. Calling you
something. Gotcha.
So here the author of the Zindri Kyotsong Rinpoche is saying that right now, you listeners, who needs to talk about, he's talking about his
audience.
So now, here, as far as you who are listening to this, what needs to be said of that? I, who am explaining it, it's difficult for me to have these kind of signs such as this. And especially nowadays, people such as all the people such as myself, we've been engaged in all kinds of negative kinds of behavior constantly. We've created negative karma, and we're still not satisfied with creating that negative karma. And this excellent body that we've obtained right now, this moment of opportunity that we've achieved at this moment, here we leave it. We simply utilize it for the activities of this world, and in that and then when we hear we see or we hear something, some kind of special good or bad thing.
So,
So when we hear about some kind of amazing good thing or bad thing in the world, and we see that or we hear about it, then we're merely people that have these signs that have been mentioned. We get tears in our eyes, or the hair on our body stands on end by seeing and hearing about just ordinary kinds of good and bad things, and we haven't gone beyond that. Since that is the case, even So we're like that. We get excited or sad about ordinary worldly things, good and bad things that occur, and so we cry about them, or we get excited such that the hair stands on the end of on end on our bodies from ordinary things, and so those kinds of signs arise for us, and we haven't passed beyond that state, and so that being the case, there's a syntax problem I'm not able to solve here. So here then, if we consider then the profound teaching on emptiness, which is beyond such objects that have been mentioned above, the ordinary worldly good and bad things, if we consider that, and then if we're not interested in this dharma that is being taught, out of lack of interest in it, we abandon it. Or even if we do have some kind of interest in it, if it's a fallacious kind of interest or faulty kind of interest, and we engage in analytical investigation of this by means of reasoning, such that we negate causality in its entirety, meaning that when one investigates emptiness, employs the reasoning by which one establishes emptiness, if in that process one does it in a faulty fashion, such that one negates causality, then one is clearly a person who is an unsuitable vessel for understanding this, and is someone who has both kinds of faults that have been mentioned above.
Oh yeah. Mewa yobi chita washing miko wala yang, tomba nyila mewa yuena yang, 아니 돈이 땡디 잠바 아니 치다 와신도 미고 와라 아니 다 땡디 중요 와라 미니 비타 챤네 시간라 사모 돈바니 땡디 잠바 치도 자라 시지 메바 땡고 와리 치도 자라 시지 메바 땡나 아니 땡네 메바 규제네 개와 쇼메고 쇼메도 봐 어 규제네 땡네 쇼메도 봐 라시지 주위 개와 가도 가나 아니 규제네 땡네 개와 가고 어 대체니 가나 텐데기 아니 텐데 징에 와라 미니 비 탑스 챤에 아니 샤바 차오
So this is as it's explained especially in the commentary on the introduction to the Middle Way, where it says that even if one has interest in this subject, if one doesn't understand it properly, then it's Mikola Mubi Yubi Jutas. So someone who is who has interest in this and if they don't understand it, then one needs to explain it to them using a method to employ a method which does not negate what the certainty with respect to dependent origination. So what this is saying is that when one investigates the nature of emptiness and establishes it through reasoning, one is doing is negating, for example, the arising of phenomena, that things arise. The negation there is eliminating that things arise by means of their own intrinsic nature, but it does not negate things arising as such. That is arising as dependent originations. So when doing this kind of analysis and presentation of emptiness, it's essential that one presents it such that the presentation does not conflict, does not negate dependent origination, the basic causality that governs all phenomena. And so again, in the course of eliminating intrinsic existence, it's essential that one does not induce the misconception that absence of intrinsic existence entails complete non-existence, and especially non-existence of causality as it's expressed in dependent origination.
Oh yeah. 天气开了，这晚的朝晚马里去吧，过晚上那些钱呢，越南让些去交过来，俺呢遇见了艰难让些去交过来，才能我打天气给告诉的，送给俺的话，我天气给他，俺搞过啊，军队干部，让些人们呢，俺呢过来就当这不，就来等了就我接我当，俺呢连当就比那些太个麻烦些个，我天气给他。
So here then, what is this passage, this whole section is essentially pointing at is that when one is explaining emptiness and one is negating intrinsic existence, one has to do this such that the person receiving the instruction understands it correctly and is not led into the mistaken view that the negation of intrinsic existence is the negation of any kind of anything whatsoever, the ability to establish things by means of reasoning, to be able to establish causality, that effects arise due to specific causes, that all of the different forms of dependent origination are valid and are demonstrable through valid reasoning. So now, if this is not explained correctly and understood correctly, then a person might be led to the conclusion that if things don't exist by means of intrinsic nature, then they don't exist at all. There's no, the emptiness of things means that they don't exist in any way whatsoever, or could be led to the conclusion that emptiness entails that there's no way to validly demonstrate and to prove the fact of causality, that effects arise from causes, So if you present emptiness in such a way that it leads the person hearing it into the extreme of sort of nihilistic view that eliminates the one's ability to establish causality and the functioning of things in general, then that's an extremely heavy kind of a mistake. So that statement then from Jay Rinpoche is a directive actually from this this noble guru, and one should not go beyond that. It's inappropriate to go beyond that that directive. And he has taught it in that way, such that. What he has said is that one needs to employ reasoning for understanding emptiness, such that it makes people suitable to be able to newly understand emptiness. La toni tope riknu mangbo sardu jope
toni tope pacha wa rini mangbo sardu jope nirundo nirundo.
One needs to do it, teach emptiness in such a way that it establishes within the listener the capability and the it's literally like the lineage or places within them the potential to be able to understand emptiness. Newly be able to understand emptiness.
Oh yeah, that teacher la, gege, nende nyamba chiku kuwa tishane. Ta tenda win nirungu duje tela. Ane samu tamba la tene payon kanchuwa te. Ta teacher song tu. Wa, oh, ただねねらさもてな님에바마세께와신도야다와테다차지도네
So here then it says that thus it's essential that one does this such in such a way that that one accomplishes the speech of the guru and the direction of the guru, and that that a person at least develops a strong motivation which will engender in them an admiration for this profound dharma. And then thus, if one teaches the profound emptiness to such a suitable vessel, not only is there no danger, but likewise in other lives as well, they'll be free from any fear of being separated from this view,
Kibushindu
Yang, So, thus, in addition, in other lives as well, then automatically all kinds of various good qualities will arise, which follow on hearing this kind of profound dharma. And one will also be, one will not have to worry about being separated from this special view. This is explained, this is referring to a passage in the introduction to the Middle Way, in which Chandrakirti says, such a person will always properly take up ethical discipline and abide in it. They'll practice generosity, and they'll depend upon compassion. They'll act in a compassionate fashion. They'll meditate forbearance, and they'll dedicate the merit of that towards awakening, and in order to. They'll do that dedication in order to liberate all sentient beings. They'll dedicate the merit of all of that to awakening so as to liberate sentient beings. And they will pay respect to the fully awakened, or to the Dzogbe Changchub Sempana, to the perfected bodhisattvas.
Oh, yeah. That point did that.
So then if a person has heard, when they listen to this profound dharma, then to the extent that they hear it and as much as they think about it, then they'll have even more, they'll be more careful to guard and to maintain all of the virtuous things that all of the activities in terms of like the extensive portion of the path which pertains to the development of virtue, like practicing ethical conduct, generosity, development of forbearance, etc. All of those things, they'll have even more interest in maintaining those properly. And if that occurs, then it's an unerring sign that this has gone to the, that one's understanding has gone to this essential point.
Yeah, that's right.
Yes.
Gibor Jetson, Losan Drogba Ye,
Demo, Sasi,
So, Saji Pogi, Juxing, Medo,
Drogba.
Sanjay